Hello everyone, welcome to Even College Digital Class. I hope you must have gone through my previous video lectures in which I have already discussed the meaning of insurance, the parties included in an insurance contract, what is an insurance contract, what are the principles of insurance contract. So whatever I have covered is the basics of insurance. So every one of us needs to understand what is insurance, because insurance is our day-to-day activities in our regular lives. Everybody is taking insurance nowadays, whether it is motor vehicle insurance or health insurance or life insurance. Everybody is taking insurance nowadays. That is why every person interested to take insurance need to understand the basic concepts of insurance so that he or she will get benefited from this, and it will be easier for him or her to get insurance contract. So in today's video lecture, I am going to cover the functions of insurance. Insurance is a very important thing, and so we have to understand what are the functions of insurance. I will discuss it in three parts. So insurance has three functions: primary function, secondary function, and other function. This all thing we will discuss in today's video lecture. So I am Manisha Manashwini Padhi, a lecturer in Department of MCOM in Finance and Control. So this is the basic outline of functions of insurance. So first one is primary function, then secondary function, and third one is the other function. What is primary function? Primary, the word means the most important function. Primary functions of insurance includes such points. Those are: this provides certainty, insurance provides protection, risk sharing provides security, last one is assistance of business enterprise. So these are the primary or the most important functions of insurance. Second one is secondary functions. These are the secondary functions. These are also important, but as compared to primary functions, these are less important. So the secondary functions include prevention of loss, it provides capital, third one is improves efficiency, economic progress, and last secondary function is judging the availability of major projects. So here this is the secondary functions, and third one is the other functions. Those are not included under primary and secondary functions. So the other functions include expansion of foreign trade, encourages savings, check inflation, self-confidence and goodwill, social security, credit facilities, and employee cooperation. We will discuss all these functions one by one. So here comes the primary functions. Under that, the first point is insurance provides certainty. The main function of insurance is to provide certainty by reducing the risks or uncertainties of events. Insurance is a means to compensate the losses caused by uncertain events. The insured can convert his uncertainties to certainties by paying premium to insurer. Insurance provides certainty. It means whatever we are doing in our day-to-day activities, those are uncertain. For example, we are using bike or we are using motor vehicles. So there is always a risk there that I can face any accident, I can face damages, I can have loss. These are the uncertainties for which insurance should be taken, so that if any kind of loss will happen, it will be compensated, the risk will be compensated. Okay? In insurance, the insured can convert his uncertainties to certainties. To convert the uncertainties to certainties, the insured has to pay certain premium amount to the insurance company. Against that premium, the insurance company will compensate if any kind of loss happens. Okay, so let's move to the next point. This is insurance provides protection. The another important function of insurance is to provide protection against the probable chances of loss. The insurance guarantees the payment of loss, and this protects the insured against any kind of suffering. The insurance cannot check the happening of the risk and event, but can compensate for losses arising at the happening of the risk event. So insurance provides protection. It means if any kind of loss happens, any kind of risk is there, against that risk, insurance provides protection. For example, if I have a factory and I am the owner of that factory, so I will be under a constant pressure that at any point of time my factory can catch fire and I can face a huge amount of loss. So if I am taking insurance for that factory, so I will be relaxed in that manner ki if my factory catches fire and I get loss, that amount of loss will be compensated. This is how insurance provides protection. Next point is risk sharing. The concept of insurance is based in the law of cooperation to share the loss. When the risk takes place, the loss is shared by all the persons who are exposed to risk. The share is obtained from each and every insured in the shape of premium. So risk sharing means, if for example 100 persons are taking insurance and paying premium for it, so this is normally we can think 100 out of 100 will not face the loss. So for example 20 persons suffered the loss. So for that compensation, other 80 persons are providing the premium. This is how it is called. The principle of insurance are included under the law of cooperation. Insurance is a cooperating device where many persons come together to pay compensation to a certain person. Fourth one is, insurance provides security. Another function of insurance is to provide security to the persons against the risk of uncertain events. The insurance provides a feeling of security against the evil effects of the uncertain events, that is risks. If any kind of risk is there in any subject matter, whether it is life, whether it is vehicle, whether it is health or anything, insurance provides security towards that particular subject matter. So it eradicates the risk included in the subject matter. Next one is assistance to business enterprise. Insurance provides help to business houses. There are heavy capital investment in the modern industry, especially in building machinery, plant, equipments, etc. These investments are exposed to loss or damage by fire, theft, accident, etc. The provision for these losses may be very costly. So insurance provides protection to these assets in return for the small payment called premium. So there is an owner of a company who owns a factory. So that factory includes heavy machineries, plants, equipment. So if that factory gets damaged, all the expensive machineries will also get damaged. So if that owner of the factory takes insurance for that particular factory, then if the loss happens, he will get compensated. So this is how insurance company provides assistance to the business enterprise by shifting the risk towards itself. Next is our secondary functions. Secondary functions included, first point, provides capital. Insurance provides capital to the industry. It provides funds for the investment. The surplus amounts received on account of premium by various insurance companies is made available for the industrial development of the country. This point tells that, for example, insurance company collects 1 crore rupees as premium from many of insured. From that 1 crore rupees, the compensation has to be made for example, 50 lakh rupees. So whatever the extra amount, which is 50 lakh rupees, is invested in different capital investments or government projects. And this is how insurance companies are growing themselves. This is also needed because insurance company has also some expenses, some capital expenditures, some revenue expenditures. It has to provide salaries to their employees. So this is a source of income for the insurance companies. Next one is improves efficiency. Insurance improves the efficiency in business by reducing the fear of losses. If a person does not have fear of loss, then he or she can work efficiently without any tension. So this is what this point says, that insurance increases the efficiency of a person. It eliminates the worries of losses and creates a sense of security, which in turn becomes a source of growth and diversification, and it makes that person more efficient. Next is economic progress. The insurance provides an initiative to work hard for the betterment of masses by protecting the society from huge losses of damage, destruction and death. So insurance company normally provides security to a person. That person will be relaxed, that person will be in a peace of mind and will work more efficiently, and his or her business will grow. That is how indirectly economic progress will be done in the country. Next is judging the profitability of major projects. Insurance also helps in judging the viability of major projects. Before insuring the assets or property of any organization, the insurer conducts a viability investigation of assets or project as a while with a view to judge the profitability of the project. So before signing any insurance contract, insurer first goes to the field. Insurer does the field of study, and after that the viability of the project, the viability of the subject matter is judged, and according to that the premium amount is fixed. So by this process the owner of that particular factory gets to know about the profitability of that particular project. So last one is our other functions. It also includes certain points. First one is expansion of foreign trade. Insurance promotes foreign trade and helps in earning valuable foreign exchange by providing security to the international traders, shipping companies, banking and financial institutions who work in the field of foreign trade. Foreign trade is the most important thing for economic development of a country. If foreign currencies are coming into a country, it means that country is getting more self-sufficient. So insurance companies help the shipping companies, foreign trading companies, foreign investors by ensuring them with the security that if they will get any kind of loss, they will be compensated. So by this, the insurance company promotes the foreign trade. For example, a person is doing export business and he is exporting something by the way of ship. So that person can take marine insurance policy. So eventually if that person having any loss by the water, then he will be compensated. So this creates a sense of security, a sense of belief in that particular company to do export and to include in the export business, and eventually this will help that company to get foreign exchange or foreign currencies into our country. Next is encourages savings. Insurance makes savings possible. These days insurance is considered to be a better alternative to invest of surplus funds in insurance policies for future saving and to get the benefits of income tax deductions. Insurance premiums are free of tax expenditure. This is very important point that it encourages savings. For example, one person has taken insurance contract and he is giving premiums. Okay, so that particular premium amount will be deducted at the time of paying taxes. This is the rule of central government. Okay, so this is how insurance provides tax exemptions and insurance encourages savings. Next is check inflation. Insurance also helps in checking the inflation. Forced saving in the form of premium reduces the spending of the individual. The saved source of production, that is capital, is used for the national development by investing them in a better way. By giving premiums to the insurance company, a kind of savings are getting included in insurance companies. And once they accumulate all the type of savings, they will be having a mutual fund of saving, a huge amount of saving, which will be invested in a capital manner, which will be invested as a capital investment in government projects, in development projects, in foreign countries, in foreign stock exchanges, which will in return give profit to all over the country. And if our country is getting more profit, then there will be a check on inflation. More amount of inflation will not be there. So insurance indirectly helps in checking the inflation. Next one is our credit facilities. Traders in a position to collect loan from various financial institutions and banks by pledging their insurance policies. So let us understand this through an example. For example, I have taken an insurance policy. I have that insurance contract with me, which has an insured amount of 5 lakh rupees. So after some time, if I want to have a loan, I am in a need to get some loan. So I can pledge, I can keep that particular insurance contract in bank as a mortgage, as a security against which I can take some loan. Okay. So, but the most important thing here, which you all need to understand, is insurance encourages savings. Insurance provides protection, but insurance is not an investment, because in investment, what we do in investment is the sacrificing of present money to earn money in future. Okay, I have surplus money of 100 rupees. I will invest it now. I am sacrificing it now and I will get profit in future. But in insurance, what is that? Okay, whatever, if I face any kind of loss, I will get compensated for that loss itself. If I am having a loss of 100 rupees, I will be compensated 100 rupees only. So insurance provides protection, insurance provides safety, but insurance is not an investment because it is not made for any profit motive. Next is employees cooperation. Employees can have a good relationship with employees by insuring against life, accident and sickness, etc. Most of the companies are getting insurance contracts for their employees for their safety. It creates a sense of belongingness of the employees towards the organization, and employees become more loyal and acts as the assets of an organization. Last one is feeling of self-confidence. Insurance creates self-confidence in insured by providing a feeling of security and safety to them. Insurance provides protection against risk. It also provides capital to the insured, which become a source of financial stability and strength. Someone after taking insurance policy gets a kind of secured, a kind of relaxed, that if I'll face any kind of loss, that will be compensated. So that person doesn't have to think of that particular amount of risk. So this creates a sense of self-confidence and sense of trust. It increases the efficiency of the person, and that person can work properly to make his or her company grow and prosper. So I hope you have understood the functions of insurance. So in the next video, I'll try to cover the types of insurance, that is general insurance and life insurance. So if you haven't watched the previous videos, please watch them. And if you are having any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I will clear all that. Thank you.